They have another modified home. And I'm talking of the flexibility that would be so essential for us further. So before we start into this, I can assure you all these procedures do not need more than half an hour of a patient's stay in the hospital. That is how we start the process. So if anybody can just tell me which one to start, I think Dr. Jesse can decide. He has already been in. Yes, we start with Agni Garbham then, because we have the Ruksha variety. Dr. Alengile, all PowerPoint. Never heard till 2010. I don't know if somebody did. But you know, all of us are very well connected with the Ayurvedic fraternity. We know good number of people in Ayurveda. If somebody was doing, we would have known it. Invariably, is my impression. I could be wrong. Next. I have been sometimes told, now why do you show the photographs of doctors, etc., etc.? And you see, this presentation is very unusual that I don't put any theory slides, because that's something global at home. I did travel quite a lot to learn from different sources, and I hope that somebody who meets me should be better than me. That's how it happens. We are not much seniors, I am sure bulk of you here are seniors to me. But I always feel anybody should make the life of his junior better than his own. So if you ever want to learn from him, that's his phone number. He's a very, very humble person, very efficient, and anybody can learn. He's a very, very simple person to engage with, and he teaches without any inhibitions. And of course, Dr. JC has well said that, you know, teaching is very important from an authoritative source. Next. So, next. This stuff. I think we'll have to put the video. We'll go next. Now, the next question is, of course, you don't have to write it down. Dr. Rashmi has the photostat of this, and you will get the circulated whenever you get whatever. We need to know where it is done. Any procedure basically has the headings, the indications, how it is done, and what is the experience part of it. This is how it happens. And where it is done is also, if we start with, you know, cervical spondylosis, or in case it has a radiating pain to the arm or the fingers, that is just the disease that we know of. We will have to realize that Agni Karma is best done once the nirkat is nearly gone. When the symptom, they say that if you have a they would say like that. So that is the stage to do. So of course it's impossible to describe everything. What I meant out of this line was that even if it is tennis elbow, of course the responses are variable. We need to always keep in mind the diagnosis, which is relatable, and the right timing, that is the keyword, of doing it. So you have this printout later to you, so that's fine. And if you can give your email address, I can always forward it, that is also fine, whichever is easy. This list is a compilation of the doctors I know of, and of course you will see their photographs later. It's a compilation of what many of us have done. So it is very authentic in that sense, and also it has the peculiarity that this is done and followed up to find a substantial relief for the next 3 to 6 months time. It's very reliable. It would not be prudent on me to convey to you either Snayu Vata or whatsoever diagnosis Snayu Vata, because we are more easily relatable with the English terminology even for the patient. So that makes it very important that we relate to known terms. Next. The list continues. That's fine. Next. It will be very quick. I think what we can do is we will show the video of how it is. It's a very common procedure. I was not very reluctant to show the Agni Karma because it's so commonly done, and I have seen it being done in Ayurveda College when I was in 2001 internship. So it's not very common, but I think Varma, yeah, that is better. That is better. Chau. And you'll see how it is done. Agni Karma, yes. There is a gentleman on arrival. Yeah, you can put that. By that we will cover up the Agni Karma.
Please play using videos.
This
one? That will take some time.
Hi, okay, Mama.
The procedure is what we need to see, and I think we will go as mute because that is fair enough. It is a procedure, and we earmark that area where it's like a tendonitis, let us say, and he was very reasonably cooperative to behave silent. So we take those areas which are the most painful, and the red hot is applied. Shalaga is better. It is not glamorous, shalaga, but then it is having more depth, that's for sure. But this has a problem that if you don't have electricity, I mean, it can go up in the government sector anytime. Then of course you can't rely on it. But this also gives results, and for a patient it looks good that, you know, there's a machine involved instead of looking at a chutiga, as they would call a shalaga. So it has a good feel. The effect is also there. And this is how the procedure is done. But before that, we ensure that he has had enough panchanam done, either in the form of Punarnavasam or Vettumaran or Rasnadipudi applied or Kottanchukar, X, Y, Z, whatever we feel that area to get dry, if you use that word. I think it is over, the procedure is over. And we'll see how. Then he was telling me, because he was being done the Varmam points, and as he was communicating to me, as you can see the K-sheet itself, he is on Maharasana, the XYZ, and whenever the Varmam points were done, he would have the results sustaining for 2 hours or 6 hours, etc. And this is the original K-sheet itself, that shows how long he was having medicine. He is not a, you know, very busy man in his life, he is not a busy businessman or official, etc. But I was wondering, if he is a very busy Indian official, will that official have the time to keep on having Maharasnadi Kashayam for more than 2 months and have no substantial improvement? That is the question. And that is the way we will have to look into every patient. And if you see it like, I think that's over. Whenever the warm-up was being done and he was finding the relief and the benefit, that would last for a few hours. And then, as you can see, after the Agni Karma is done, that area, I mean, if you put the video on with the audio, he says that the pain is nearly nil, that we see a lot of pain. But we are interested about his range of movement, that matters the most in this. And somebody who could reach only his right buttocks, as you can see, he's reaching his left buttocks now, nearly. Can anybody claim with honesty that they will get the same results by having Maharasnadi Kashayam for another 1 month? I would really doubt it, and of course nobody would really agree to that. So what I meant was, in this simple video, doctor, stop here. I mean, we'll go to other feedback, then reverse. Yeah, as you see, that was done in August 2012, and then next when he arrived again. So I make videos of these, like portion by portion. It's like a case diary, if you call it, in a digital format, to see how long it sustains, because it's very important. The patient will ask, koravavitum etra nalateku. There's a recurrence always happening in most of the locomotor or musculoskeletal, there's always a recurrence possibility. So as you can see, there is think we can show that August 1. August 3rd. I think we can take October 2nd. That is better. So we have at least 2 months somewhere. Yes, 2nd October. And there's more and more to it, but still. And as you can see what it does, or to see how long it sustains. The point would be like this. If he is having these medicaments at home, he will easily have close to 200 rupees to 250 rupees expense a week, means close to 1000 rupees. And with this Agnikarma, of course, we do it free because we have our academic interest in documenting. But even if you charge in your private OPD for 200 rupees for Agnikarma, you know how much time is spent and whatever, it's still a better deal for the patient to save some money, and of course save the time, and most important, the health. And without great effort, a decent procedure fees can be taken. And he still, after 2 months also, he is able to touch his left buttocks, and also he is describing. Because only two people can speak here, either me or he. So I just mute him. And as I said to you, these things will be the website, so you can always listen to what it is. So this is how the sustaining happens. So this is a Roksha variety of Agnikarma. And now my next, I think we will close the video of Roksha Agnikarma. And if we have the Sneha Agnikarma, I think, 1 second, doctor. If you can just make that, yes. Okay. That, yeah, please, please. And there's still 14 January 2013, I mean, the following close to 5 to 6 months and further also, the result is sustaining. We don't waste the time here, we just jump forward. Just to show that it is documented in those segments. Next, to the chronic 50 years headache, Spanish Camilla, yeah. I will just not show the whole length of it. She's a foreigner, of course, I had to close her eyes, etc. She was having headaches for more than 50 years, nearly 50. She was 65 something when she came to me. So this lady had the best effect by Agnikarma. Nasya, nothing doing, etc. Somebody who was having the two ideas, I show this to you. One, that you can do Agnikarma even on the head. It was my teacher. I mean, she's my teacher, but she's also my official chief also, Dr. Vedi Unidan. She's very, 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 very efficient and very famous clinician. She's a DM of Kottayam now, as of now. So she gave me the encouragement for the head Agnikarma, which I was a bit reluctant to do. Because typically, you know, Svedana is not great for head, I mean, this way, and people don't really feel comfortable either. But anyway, the lady who was taking nearly every other day the painkillers for more than 50 years as a regular thing, like a daily effect, she came down to a situation of once a week, once in 10 days, painkiller, and that she still sustains even after 1.5 years of doing this. So I was imagining, it's not that we don't have, you see, she's from Spain and they have the best quality in Europe, etc., whatnot. So allopathy, don't teach them, they have enough of best allopathy, maybe more than India, who knows. It's not that our science doesn't have it, it's that we don't realize it. That's the point. And it's also the point that it's not that we don't realize it, we perhaps do not share it. That's the pity. So that's precisely why the idea is, we need to realize it, we need to document it, we need to communicate to it, and we need to spread it. And if people know that we can do it, they will definitely come to us. That's for sure. You see, nobody has to be told in Kerala, Manjapitta Mana Ottamuli and go for Kiranali, etc. Of course, it's not perhaps effective for a liver cancer, who knows. Maybe it's only for hepatitis A, B or C. It's such a common knowledge. So we need to have that strength and the conviction to tell the public, look, this condition, I will help you better than XYZ system of medicine. No offense to any system of medicine. So I think it is just to show you that it is doable. I think I will see. Yeah, that's fine. Just that it is doable at the head area also. Basically, I will now conclude the Roksha Agnikarma of, I think it is done already. Maybe in the next slide. Maybe the next slide. It comes. Yes, yeah, I will take that. Yes. So there are 2 points that are to be left in the Agnikarma. The first question is where to do. I am not talking of chronic headache. So it's very easy. I mean, you have to show the patient the video. I have had situations where patients had it has happened. many a times. It just depends on the need and the interest of the patient also. So I think that's fine. I think we will change it. Yeah. Three things to conclude in Lokshagin Karma. One, we have the indications, yes, but when to do. It's not where, the diagnosis where, but also the spot where. You have to touch a certain spot. Invariably, these are the areas of the hormone point, as we call it, the thumbnail system. And it's easily learnable, you know, if you invest some time and effort to it. These points would be very tender. So tender that the patient would not even sometimes allow you. That's kind of a nail cutter, if you can call it that, a localized one, or sometimes also a trigger point. So this is the spot where to do, and of course the indications you have as a list. The second point is, when to do in terms of the fact a Pagal Epod, if you call that way, a stage Epod, which means normally it's better to have at least a week of Pachana locally and internally. Be it Amrodhram, Rasarindadi, Puranavadi, Puranavasam, Vettumaran, XYZ, or Mutralam, Shobaharam, Amaharam, Padinam, whatever. And also locally, Kottanchukadi, Janamayadi, not necessarily, mostly either Kottanchukadi, Rasnadi, kind of paste, or Dhanyanadhar, XYZ, with a Ruksha idea. Once you clear off that edema that is gross, then you act on the local. It's like dropping a bomb on the spot. This is when it has to be done. Why I say so, when I started initially in Kuruvilangad, my first area of doing it, the results were so fantastic, and I have no shame to confess it. I know this video will be going into the internet and people will know it about it, and they will know what mistakes I made in the initial days, but I don't want others to make the same mistakes I did. If somebody wants to make a mistake, make a newer one and teach me also his mistake. That's what I would prefer. So the impact was so much with the Agni Karma that patients, a doctor, even in the Pollichera, Atiyah, so Adeyo even. Of course, I too was doing it as a, you know, not much experience at that point. So I started doing left and right. Nalla chance. I mean, they are volunteering for it. Why to miss it? I'm very frank. As I said, I don't know if you should be here with us outside the Ayurvedic fraternity, but that's how it happened. I have no shame to acknowledge that. What happened? The ones who came fresh and who were enthusiastic at this Agni Karma were not responding the same as the previous ones. That led to a contemplation that in them, I did it quite quickly and faster without waiting for that Pachana to get over, etc. So that is very important, because the expectation of the patient is very high by virtue of the experience of the person who brought him to you. So we can't let that down. But of course, I was learning at that point. And I had this feedback from Dr. Sajeev and Dr. Rajesh also. Dr. Sajeev is a CMO, he's in Karnapuri now. He's a Marman specialist. And Dr. Rajesh Kaiman is in Karnapuram now. He's a Swastabiri. They also had the same feeling and experience. So this is very important for you to be conveyed here. Now the last point of Ruksha Agni Karma. Can I do it? I've had many young, of course, you are very senior to me, so I mean this is not applicable to you, but those who are junior to me, at least by age, I've had many youngsters who interacted with the doctor, can we also do it? I said, yes, if I can do it, anybody can do it better than me. That is the golden rule. Anybody who can ensure that the Samranitiri, if you call it, live Samranitiri, does not cross a tissue paper on touch, is qualified to make this happen. I know, maybe some Vyajavaidan is looking into my website later, maybe he tries doing it. I don't care. A friend of mine, Dr. Sri Rajesh K. Swastham, now he's a tutor kind of on deputy. He said, I said, who the bloody hell cares? I'm sorry to use that word. If the Ayurvedic people cannot do it, let those who wanted to do it. That's my policy. You can't let the public have suffering. We know many times, I'm not supporting Vyajavaidya, nothing like that, please, don't get me wrong. They are the ones who touch the patient. They are the ones who do the procedures. I'm not being critical to anybody. I'm not accusing anybody. But it's a fact that if you keep sustaining yourself with only prescription, you're not sure how long you are in the field. I know very well, when I do that uploading, there will be resistance and objections, but I think, okay, you have the chance, you can do it, you're more qualified. If you do it, you don't have the problem from an unqualified person. So in future, if any of you see these videos, please understand me. I'm not trying to be offending my own people. I'm just trying to make sure that those who are interested can do it. And why I say that it is relevant to to make this information open is that I took more than 10 years to learn it. It's a shame on me. Maybe it was my problem, but I did not have people who could guide me on this to be done. It was Matthew sir in 2010 who made me into it. 9 years I lost. And not only me, the patients who came to me. But you see, you can learn from a source if somebody teaches you. By the time you reach a source to learn, your days are going away. You're losing your days, and you're losing the chance to help somebody. And the third part of that, as I said to you, was if you can manage not to pierce through a tissue paper using a Savarana theory, then you're qualified. It is as simple as that. Because I do not want Anushastras to be considered a domain of the Shalya PG people only. No offense. No offense to PG people and Shalya Tantra. Why I say so, I have felt so bad. Some people have said, Adu, okay, namada. Come on, yaar, we are Ashtanga Vaidyas. You can't say Anushastra is only for Shalya PG. Of course, they are good and great, no doubt. But it's for everybody. Every Vaidyan has to do it. So, we get into the Snehagni Karma, which I learned from. Please, I have no grudge against anybody, but I prefer, like all of you, to call an apple. I would never prefer to call it an orange. We have to talk straight and plain. Not everybody may like it, but then that's how it is. Because there are some things that I could not agree. When I was taking classes somewhere, I did have feelings from some people that some things have to be done by some few people only. And perhaps this was a curse we carried for so many centuries. Some people only doing some things. It doesn't serve the purpose. No allopathy doctor has lack of status because they share. I hope you will agree to that. Because they share and they grow. It's about growth together. It's not an individual's growth only. And the Sneha variety, if you see that preparation, this is a real bomb in one sense of it. Because you are putting something like 150 degrees Celsius of boiling oil on somebody. So it has to be real precise. And I think the audio is... Yeah, I think my video can speak instead of me. That is fair enough. Then you will have
taught me the Sneha variety of Agni Karma.
What else about next? We will see next. I think we will manage without me speaking there. Because I'm some things I can, I think we'll put this on. Let us keep it mute and we will go through it. Because I think we should rush to complete as many possible.
Mute?
Yes, mute is fine. Because if it is enlarged, all that you need is Erkila. Even this Ummatanela is fine. Hathura leaf is also fine. Arka leaf is good. You need a marker pen, I mean plain pen is fine. A marker is just to make that area where to do. You will put a plaster there, mark is also fine. You need a simple tabi and you need a spoon. I mean, why I make this much of minute detail? Next day somebody wants to do, should be doing. We should not be kept pending. And of course, I will be leaving this DVD with Dr. JC and you can license with him. If anybody wants to take a copy, it's all everybody's. And so this is how we prepare. And in the corner you have the Katarvada. I had a very small thing at that point. Should be a bigger one. This is just for showing case. My garden didn't have a bigger one. But it has a bigger one. So next we will change it. This is the material that is needed. I am explaining it, but I think I will make it fast. The next. And the Ela should not be broken off, no? So Vatuga, I don't know what the English word would be for Vatuga. But anyway, that is how it is. So, this has to be made like, you know, Ayapadidhiduka, whatever you can say in English. We'll change it. And then we say that Nurki Nurki, you know, make small pieces and you're putting in that. It's a very easy procedure. As I say, if I can do it, anybody can do it better than me. That's a simple idea. So you make the small pieces, you put into that, and this you will be hitting next. First we will make the procedure, then the indications are easier, and then you are having this heating up. So this is an important procedure where you have to make sure that the patient is not watching it. It could be very uncomfortable when they know there's a fireball going to fall on them invariably. But of course, when I do to my patients, I show them this with their informed consent. So when you make this, see forward. If you make a little forward, you will have sometimes the fireballs coming, all poga and fire, etc. It's all possibilities, but you have to make sure that it is not well fried nearly. When you have this, next. When you have the situation of fume coming and this, you know that it's really hot. And when you teach it to your therapist, if it's your private hospital or XYZ, make sure that he realizes you are the one who is teaching it, controlling the whole thing. So sometimes you have such miscommunication. So this is all possibilities. This is why I wanted to show you that fireball. We don't want this to be seen for a patient. This is for us, for our doctor's understanding. Next. And then we have, because I am not doing on a patient, it is this one, we can't shoot and make a patient in the next video. So what we do then is, of course there is a video, audio there. Supposing this is the point, as I will be writing there, the Burman point or the trigger point or XYZ, whichever, there are some points that would say, patient will say, Ruksha, Ushna, whatever XYZ, nothing will work. They will look like a lump. It's not seeable, it's feelable easily. And mostly the whole spine area, even of course it could be thigh area and even calf area, there are so many areas that it will have. Only this can break it. It's as good as a laser precision bomb, because the heat has to really go deep. And as I have made that very clear there, so this is, it has to be fuming, huh? Here it is, the fume has gone, as you see in that. And I have placed the leaf in such a way that it is made like a, not a giri, but not something like it. And then we, it's like when we do it, we say like to the patient, now start exhaling. 3, 2, 1, and 0 is the dropping. Otherwise, they end up having that kind of, if you don't tell them, then the other one is like uluk, they may have some tendency. They're already afraid. You are telling them 150 degree boiling oil, and then you're telling them this is going to fall on you, and they're getting prepared, and they feel such uncomfortable. So it's very important, encourage them to exhale, and tell them at 0 point, there's a dropping. So next. And after that, you have a situation where, yes, this is the trigger point, and as I told you in that, is the leaf is really boiling, and that fumes are there, when we are putting in that package. And similar trigger point, whichever, the tender point, and then why I keep the scutter has to be much more bigger, thicker and bigger, because the moment the patient says a tanupang poi, we may have the tanup in our hand, but they will say a tanup poi, you have to put a fresh coating, because it's 150 degrees Celsius boiling. So yeah, this has to be actually fuming when we do it. And here you place like vertical and horizontal, and that is, I mean, that's, I think we can change. We can change. I hope we have the next. Because this is very easily doable at OPD level, even if it's in private hospital, even government. It takes some time, but it is doable. But if you're fixing things which is not responding even to Basti, and after 4 to 5 months, you're feeling ashamed of seeing the same patient, finish it off as early as you can, then it's easier. And at that point, I don't have a pointer in my hand, but you have to ensure, I don't know if it has a pointer,
You have to ensure that
this would have a leakage from here, this area, this, because when you press, it's a possibility your own hand can get burned.
So this has to be taken care of, that's spilling over. But when you press, you see it's like 3-2-1, one shot and up. You're not holding on there. That is a key point.
So these are very minute things. I don't know how much I can convey here, but I would try to, that when you put that, it's just in Rukshavikarma Ayrati Unna. The space you have to apply the Ruksha rod, red hot, is possible. Here, Ayrati Unna is not possible. I don't know. Like kind of thing.
So I don't know, I hope I did not make it. Was it me who made this? No, the current one. So what is important is the stay time is very, very important. We have to make sure that we don't keep it for a longer time, because that will have a burn for sure. I've had people with foreigners who had the burn. It was very fair skin, no? It's not like brown like me. So it is very important that we make all these caution or a consent. You think around a procedure, either you do laser, which is also effective, you go for needling, which is not very comfortable, or you go for neural therapy, which not everywhere in Kerala you have. But so you give all the evidence, say this is how the procedure. But I would say it's not meant to discourage you. It is possible to make Sneha Agni Karma without any complication. So long as you have the Katarvada fresh, it's better to order up to 1 kg Katarvada. Keep on cooling it after it is done. No problem at all. But very fair skin, we have to be a bit careful about it. Now coming to the last point, I think I will see it here. In the PowerPoint segment. Where do we do it is the question. This was the procedure. And I really wanted to spend more time on Snehagni Karma, because it is not very, very commonly done. Close, I think. Reverse to the Snehagama slide level. Reverse. Important that we mark that area, and I don't know how many of you can see it, but this is somebody whose the trigger points were elicited, and it's very easy. You know, if you feel tender to that point, then it is a trigger point. Now it's very tender, very tender, and it's very typically found in this area. You know, this. Along this medial border, I mean, it can happen anywhere. You say like a myofascial knot, you call it. And that, no, let us not waste the Rasnadi Pudis and the Kottanthukadi Pudis when we know the trigger point will not melt with it. I strongly believe the medicines we are using now are not the ones that we inherited from our forefathers. These are the medicines we have taken away in advance from our next generations. So we have a responsibility to conserve these medicines. And that is precisely in the initial introduction I had mentioned, that we are able to conserve and save the medicines as much by these procedures. Why to use Punarnavadi Kashayam for 1 month? Of course, people like my father-in-law who owns a pharmaceutical may not be really happy if their medicines don't get sold. I mean, that's a different story.